And let's go back to the desktop and your session progress. We create a new folder, 20.apns demo, and we copy paste the previous project. And memory management of project, you copy paste. Okay. Again, we don't have to create any folders and all. It's at app delegate level. Everyone? Now, to use notifications, okay. Now, I would recommend in iOS 10, there was a lot of changes happening in notifications. Lot of changes. They have changed the entire architecture. The callbacks have changed. In iOS 9, it works differently. In iOS 10, it works differently. And iOS 10 onwards, they are continuing with the same framework. Now, going further. So, in iOS 9, by September, it will be last. So, I would recommend if you are making any apps, do not support iOS 9. Say 10 and above. Because push notification is a basic feature which every app is expected to have, right? Because nowadays apps are not iOS centric or Android centric, it's cloud centric, right? So notifications will be there here and there, right? So we cannot compromise, okay? So trust me, for 9.0, if you do a lot of changes, you're not, means not long term. So anyways, you don't waste your time, right? So what happens is, what we want for 10? There's a framework called user notification. Okay. Everyone. Now see, there's a very important thing which we have to do. Project. Now here, at general level, now there's a setting called deployment target. You see this? Everyone? It's 11.2 in mind. Someone will have 11.1, someone will have 11.0. It's like from which OS you want to. So I will say I will support 10 and above. You can go till 8, as of current. But supporting 8 and 9 in iOS is a bit risky now. Because in iOS, it's not like an Android where, you know, people move. They upgrade. Okay. So there is iPhone 5 supports 10. iPhone 5 doesn't support 11. So anyways, everyone is on 10. Okay. And anyways, when you want to create a new build, it's 5S and above. 5S and above, 11 and above. Still, we are giving 10. You know? So anyways, you will say you want to support an iPad 2, which was launched in 2010. It's not allowed. Your new code will never go, will not be loaded in that. The update will never go. Okay? So you cannot do anything in that anyways. Okay? So please make sure you use 10 and above. That's an ideal way. In Android, we use API 18 and above. Even people say don't go for API, you go for Lollipop and above. But still, 10% market share is huge. Okay, so I go for Jelly Bean and above. Okay. Now here, we know how to add a library, right? Plus sign, user notification framework, right? Now I don't want UI framework. I just want notification. Okay. User notification. Everyone? Edit. Now, if you would have used 8.0 or 9.0, yahan pe aapko optional karna padta. Clear what I mean to say? Because input mein crash hota nahi to. Okay. So I am not giving any 8 or 9. I'm taking 10. So I go to app delegate again. I'll say import. Ryan? Now, there's one. There's a delegate called UN User Notification Center delegate. Okay, just type UN User Notification Center delegate. It's an informal protocol. That's the reason you won't be finding any error, right? Anyone getting error? Right? Let's go inside this delegate. So it's Universal Notification User Notification Center delegate. No, it stands for user notification. This is framework name. UN is user notification. And then it says user. Clear? It's a new delegate added in 10.0 and above. Huh? Prior to 10.0, we never used to have this all delegate. It was happening in app delegate only. Okay. When I click here, have you imported this? So everyone inside this, right? It says what user notification center will present, and there's one more optional button, did receive. See these two methods, right? There are two methods. Anyone? You have to implement both the methods. Okay. So pehla, and I'll discuss what these two methods are meant for. Okay. Anyway, they have given the description, but then we'll see. So you just go to bottom, at the bottom of your app delegate, you just implement them. Both are void methods, huh? Everyone got these two methods? The center delegate is through multiple agents. The class. Everyone? Now, see, these both have a different. Initially to iOS 10, we used to have only one common function. We used to get something called did receive remote notification. In application delegate, we have one. UI application delegate, there is one optional method called did receive remote notification, did receive local notification. Now here it says what? Will present. This will get triggered when your app is in foreground. Okay, I'm presenting that. So you take a call. So when your app is in foreground, you won't get that notification panel, the alert. So you will get an event. Now from here you can create a view, and that view will be loaded on a window, because a user might be anywhere on the screen, right? So aapne window pe add kar liya to kya hoga, wo sabse upar aa jayega. Okay, that code you have to write on your own. The view bana ke usko animate upar niche kar sakte ho aap, kaise bhi karo, theek hai, wo yahan pe aayega. This will get called when your app is in background state. Dono different. App launch, app terminate wali cheez alag ho gayi. Teen states se, app in foreground, app in background, and app in terminate state. Terminate state will take later on. Clear, everyone? Now, what is your intention? To get that payload, the JSON payload. Baki is sab cheezo sam, we are not at all interested. We are interested how to get that payload. That payload used to be user info. The word property name was user info, which was a dictionary key value pair. All keys will be given at a notification level. And depending on the key, we will get a value and we'll process it, right? Now, issue was what? Prior to iOS 10, it used to come as a parameter only. User info karke. Date received remote notification, user info. The entire payload was directly. Here, the problem was, where is that user info? It's there. Okay? So, I tell you where it is. Now, what we do? We write print statement. Aur abhi notification kaise test karoge? So, we run an app in foreground. Let a notification come. Because running on a background and debugger, it's a very cumbersome process. App, it's like an Android where you connect and logs are still coming. iOS mein bahut ghumana padta hai profiles mein. Right? So what we do, basically we run a foreground. Notification payload is same only. When they come in foreground, background or terminated state. So we always test on a foreground. It will run. It will run. If it's coming here, it cannot say it's not coming in terminate state. Impossible. The statement is impossible. It will run in all the three states. Okay? So ek state mein compare kar lo, baki sab mein bhi hoga hi wo. Okay? So now how you do that? Now we should write this annotation, because I'm supporting 9 and 10 both. It was 2 years before when 10 was launched, right? So if you have something like that, you have to see available. Aisa code likhna padta hai. Aap likh lo. Suppose you are supporting some callbacks which are only available from some version, right? So if that's the case, this is the annotation, right? So it tells if this code gets compiled in 8 or 9, it will not get a compile. Okay, this code will be ignored. So function pointer won't get created basically. Clear? In 9 and 8. So this is the way we right now in your case, in our case, it's not needed because we are doing 10 and above. But in future, there might be new APIs coming, right? In 11, 12. And you might come across that situation where you want to support both the things. So this is the way we create. Okay. Now the question comes that payload. The important is that payload, right? Once a payload comes to your app, and that's exactly the same payload what you are sending, your integration is over. That means that infrastructure is done. Ek karo ya hazar notification bhejo abhi. Kuch farak nahi padne wala. It's done. Now there cannot be a possibility that mobile app has an issue. Sometimes server teams say notification nahi, apan bolte ye nahi aaya. Bole nahi bheja humne. Yahan pe to issue nahi. Aap bindaas bol sakte. Kuch kar hi nahi sakte aap. What do you have to do? You are receiving, right? You are not sending. Issue is always at a server end. So always make sure you just do this infrastructure. One test. Test notification bhejwa do. Ho gaya, khatam. Then you just have to do handling. The handling is all depend upon your cases. How you want to handle, right? Now, so what are those? How do you get payload? Payload is not easy to get. It's like in depth. So I'll just give you that. I also don't remember. Trust me that it took me 2 hours to get this payload when it was first time came. So I'll say payload. Or you can say user info. Basically, the term used to use was user info. So basically, this notification object has a request. That request object has a content, and that content has your, this is an important dictionary. Okay. And this dictionary is the one which you get the to know whatever information is coming in that payload. Clear? Okay. And best practice says use small initials for keys in payload. Your payload is very, very limited in size, right? Android is huge. iOS, it's very limited. 2 years before that, it was like 255 characters only. 1 byte.
Android
4 KB. 4 KB. 2 KB iOS mein bhi ho gaya. Everyone? Abhi yahan pe wo kaisa aayega, right? To yahan ka bhi main bata deta hu. So I don't remember. I just skip response dot notification dot request dot content dot user info. Now in future, in iOS 12 or iOS 13 or 14 or 15, again notification changes, it's called back. Code khali yehi aadna user info nikalna. बस वो इतना आपने को करना खाली कैसे भी करके यूजर इनफो ला लिया काम खत्म क्लियर एवरीथिंग एल्स इज स्टिल द सेम वी जस्ट नीड एट पेलोड ओके डन एवरीवन प्रोसेसिंग इज ओवर नाउ द क्वेश्चन कम दिस इज अ पेलोड राइट दैट यू आर डूइंग स्टेप नंबर 6 व्हिच इज द लास्ट स्टेप ऑफ योर प्रोसेस राइट व्हाट अबाउट द फर्स्ट स्टेप इज नीडेड राइट So we'll now focus on first step. Now for first step, you have to implement some callbacks of UI application delegate. Trust me, before 10, everything was in UI application delegate only. In 10.0, they have changed the callbacks. Okay, clear everyone? So it's okay, now processing. Now let's go to UI application delegate protocol, everyone. The first protocol which we saw on day one. So you just keep on scrolling, you'll get some protocol called did receive 949. Yes, and did failed, both. See, this is it. I have on 436. See, it's that's in 3.0. So if someone tell when the notification came, it came from iOS 3.0 and no. Local notification came in 4.0. Local notification came after that. It's a did register remote notification device token. This data is your token. And then did fail. Okay. So these are two methods which you have to implement. Did fail when it will get called? When user say cancel. Clear everyone? Or suppose it accept. It runs the app, goes in settings and then say notification off. The next line pe launch hoga na app, to wapas it trigger hoga. Every time your app launches, na, this both method will get triggered. Because you have already enabled push notification on your app. Every launch, these two methods will get triggered on its own. It doesn't have any fixed sequence. It might take a connectivity to IPNS for time. Aayega. Clear? But ye guarantee call hoga. These two methods I'll copy in app delegate. So before processing, I can put these two methods. So here we what we'll do, we put those into a preference called device token. So in failure we say NA, and in actual we store the device token. And then whenever you want to send to the server, we send it accordingly. Okay. Once it's in the preference, it's there locally stored, right? So these all things we use preferences only, user defaults. Ye kisi ko paas bhi chala bhi gaya to kuch rukne wala nahi hai. But I don't want to get plist and all those things. I'll use a system preference directly. Okay, clear? So some things are very obvious, very small. You know, if nothing gonna happen. Why to create database, plist and all? Use preference directly. Okay. Now, how do you convert? This is data bytes. Now we have to convert them into a string. Now, when you convert them into a string, now what issue happens? You know, your token comes this way. It's hex number, but it's not a hex. Okay. Luckily, it's a hex right now. This is a, like 40 digit. Blah 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 numbers will come. Obviously hex doesn't have U and all. I'm just saying if you pass this string directly na, on your server, these tokens are not valid. The valid token is this. So first thing you have to process, you will convert the data into string. And then you replace all this special character which are coming na from now. ये था मैं तो iOS 3 की बात iOS 3 से कर रहा हूँ मैं ये. Okay. I don't know अभी change हुआ कि नहीं हुआ. मेरा तो code वही चलते रहता है. अगर it's coming this way directly, chalega, wo code execute won't return anything. I know this much, this was used to come. Okay, angle bracket. So I'll just write the code for that, right? Now this is the way we, there's no way out. You have to use NS mutable string, the legacy string, because replacing the characters is, there's an easy function in mutable string. So basically what I'm doing is, now this all thing, it started coming with a new version of Swift. Pehle data hota tha, NS jab ye aane laga, to hum khali replace maar dete hai. Compiler jo bolta hai, we do it that way. Okay. So first thing, I'm converting that into a token. Then I'm saying this token as string, Swift string. So I'm able to convert them into mutable string. I don't want mutable string. I want a Swift string. And then we are writing replacing with the character less than with blank, greater than with blank, space with blank, right? And then I'm creaming it. Okay. And then what I'm doing is I'm storing that into the token key mein. And in fail, what I'll do in fail, I'll store as a, we use NA. Okay. It depends upon your company to company, what you define as a default value, because that server guys will have to use it, right? They will fire the query on the database saying only those user which has no non-NA, you'll pass the payload, right? Everyone? And you have to use threading mechanism, threaded queue mechanism to throw a, at a time you can only give 1000 payload to APNS, okay? iOS or Android. Normally we use a queue mechanism. So infinity tak chala jayega automatically. Thank you. Okay, then only that alert will come and done. Okay, then I'll show you how we do handle. Okay, I can share you that code, it's okay. Anyway, then obviously those classes will be different for you guys, but I have created one util class only directly which handles everything from registration to handling everything. Okay. Now to initiate this, right? This callback won't call immediately. There is some settings you have to do at a launching level. Then alert will come. On that alert, then this will start. Okay. So that is inside your date finish launching with option. Okay. Here. You can do here also, you can do after the it's irrespective. Okay. So here you have to write some code. Here you have to do two things. One is to ask the user to register for notification, and second, to get triggered if app was terminated and you received a notification. So how will you come to know whether the app is launched because of notification or is a normal app launch, right? So you see this dictionary, this launch options. It gives you all the information whether the app is launched because of local notification, because the app is launched because of a remote notification, because app has been launched because there's some file transfer happened. Everything is here. Okay, so you have to check for those key depending upon your requirement, right? Right now we have a requirement of launch of remote, right? So if it's about remote, then you will get a payload. If you payloads up, aage ja sakte ho kaam. Okay. So that how you, and second thing we have to do is the registration. So now this is a this is your center where you set the delegate, then only those two callbacks will get triggered. Okay, that's first thing. Second, राइट कर लो, एक सेकेंड का काम है. ना बस हो गया, बस हो गया. अब इसके आगे कोई कोड नहीं है. सो इट्स iOS 10 एंड अबव में यही यूज करना है. उसके पहले एक और तरीका होता था, पर आई वुड से सजेस्ट यू गो फॉर iOS 10 एंड अबव ओनली. सो इट टेल्स हाउ यू वांट. नाउ सी, दिस इज ऑल लेगेसी वन. Right now, there is no nothing called alert. You don't get alert. If you have seen iPhone in 2007, 8, 9, 10, 11, we should get alert for notification, you know. Cancel, view, करके ऐसा alert आते देते थे. Panel था ही नहीं पहले. So, वो alert दिखाना है, sound चाहिए कि नहीं चाहिए, badge चाहिए कि नहीं चाहिए, वो बता रहा है. Okay? So, what we say, you request for all the options. Suppose you say your notification will never have a sound only. तो फिर sound हटा देना उसमें से. ओके, तो आपका नोटिफिकेशन कभी साउंड देगा ही नहीं. इवन इफ यू डोंट प्रोवाइड एनी साउंड एट अ सर्वर लेवल ना, इट शो द डिफॉल्ट साउंड. ओके, सो इफ यू डोंट वांट ओनली, यू कैन रिमूव इट. सो इट इज दिस वे. इफ यूजर हैव ग्रांटेड अ परमिशन, देन यू हैव टू डू समथिंग. And user have not granted a permission, then you do something. You know, suppose you want to show an alert. Okay, boss, all important notification won't come. Are you sure? Okay. And then you can take the user to a setting apps. There's a way. You can go to setting apps and then make it on. So all those things you can do. Okay. And once the permission is granted, na, this won't get executed again and again. It will only get executed first time. Then alert come na. This app needs to read your blah 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 blah. Don't you go there. Now completion handler comes in the background thread. I'm getting everything on my main thread. Even if you are adding anything out here, alert to alert, you have to create a main thread. Huh?
Why use brackets?
Where? I just write it. Current request. Ah, yes, they go. Yeah, na? So options mein kya dalunga? Dot badge. Dot sound. Then I'll put this way. Remember, enter. Enter करोगे तो boolean पे आप क्या करोगे? Granted an error. और यहाँ पे कोड आ गया. Clear everyone? और फिर मैं dispatch लूँगा. यहाँ पे मैंने if granted लिख लिया. Done? Got it?
Yeah.
Shall I move ahead? So there's one thing you have to do, last step.
I was asking this thing actually. We can do this particular chunk of code at any place, right? Where we need a pop-up. It's not required to call at the launching the application while launching the application, right?
But normally it's always people refers at a launch only.
Then maybe some required at some panels we need at the particular click on the button, then we need a push notification. No, I mean we need to allow people.
Then we can do that way also.
Yeah.
Now once you're done this, you have to call registration, register. For one second, sir. Okay. It's an app. Okay. Here you see this application object. Yes, you have to say application dot register for. So then your this will get called device token and all. See everyone? So once the user grants permission, then only you can request for token and all. So this is for your two callbacks, and this is for your this. Okay. Now, in iOS 10, what happened was, prior to iOS 10, we used to use these launching options. Okay, launch option we used to use to check whether it's a local notification or remote notification, right? But in iOS 10, this user notification center ne kya kiya hai? Ki agar app background mein hai, ya app launch hota hai, and everything is synced with your permission. It'll call this method only. Clear everyone? Okay. And foreground may call over. Okay. But suppose I want to show that if let condition. Suppose you have other keys. So remote notification useless right now. But there are a lot of keys like Bluetooth, open URL, lot of keys are available. There are plenty of keys. There are plenty of ways your app can get launched. Okay. So all those keys, how do you all manage, right? So you can say if let. Now see, there's a condition. I will show you what it is. Suppose you get one object from anywhere. Is remember get apps. So you use apps equal to get apps. Then you have to do something depending on whether apps is nil or not nil. So what do you want to write next line? If app is not nil, you will perform, else you not perform, right? Now in Swift, to make things more cleaner and easy, they have merged that two statement, getting the access of the object and checking whether it's nil or not nil, in one thing itself, saying if let. If let statement, what it does, if let, and then you give the equation of your object. If let app equal to get provided dot get apps, and then a curly bracket. That curly bracket will be executed when, you know, when apps is not nil. Else you can write the else part. Clear everyone? It's the same thing only. Aapka khali ek statement ko combine kar diya. There's something called if let guard. Jab aapko else execute karna hai, if nahi karna hai. To aap wo condition pe guard likho. To else ke liye jayega wo. Clear everyone? So now here obviously you have to check with what? Launch option. So it'll tell launch option value for that key. Agar wo not nil aaya, that means wo uske liye launch hua, right? Because every value has an object. Okay? So if that object exists, not nil means the launch was happening because of remote notification. If object is nil, it was not because of that. Clear everyone? So I'll extract the object value from this launch option, right? For that particular key, these keys are very defined. There are a lot many keys defined here. Mera kya ho gaya? It went. Mine, something went wrong. Okay. There are plenty of keys, okay, which has the objects. So how do you do that? So what I am writing here is something like this. If let, this is my variable. So something like this way we are writing. If I want to write for that get apps, the same thing I would have written this way. If let apps equal to provider dot get apps. Okay. Clear? Now you have to make sure this function should return a nullable value. If get apps the required value return kar raha hai na, if let will never run. If let only runs only on a nullable variables, or any function which runs gives you an optional variable with question mark. Okay, so aisa if let is the else when you can. So your code is much more compact. So here what I'm doing, I'm checking whether notification is because of this key. Okay, there are a lot many keys such like remote notification, local notification, Bluetooth, open URL. Now when I went, it went into a blackout screen of my. Okay. So if this is true, so basically notification is, so this will return me an object, right? Every key returns an object, and that object you should know what type it is. You will come to know. So notification has a payload, right? Ye aapka payload ho gaya. Key value pe. Okay. So this is your user info. But anyway, this user info is pointless because nowadays that also. Anyway, that did receive will get call irrespective. So we don't consider this. Prior to iOS 10, did receive used to not get call. So we used to handle this way. is to get a payload from this dictionary. Clear, everyone? So I got a payload, then I can do whatever I want to do. So from this if condition, we used to then set up the environment of the notification on launch. Suppose notification of because of chat, and you want to navigate that user to the chat screen from the home screen. So wo home screen aata tha, fir check karte the preference mein. Ye hai kya ki? So usko next screen pe leke jao immediately. You see that lot of apps, right? First launch screen happen, and then next screen it takes immediately. This way we handle at the app delegate level. We app delegate has the entire flow. Okay. Everyone clear? So all three position I have given you the user info, but this user info is pointless since iOS 10 and above. Okay, because eventually this will get called. So if you have a call, hoga, to fir wahan pe kyun likhna hai? So this is the way. It's a call if let statement. Okay, when you have a nullable object getting returned, so instead of having two statement, you can compare two statement into one statement by saying if let. This becomes a constant. Huh? तो आपका एक if let string डाला और फिर उसको आप अपडेट करने जाओगे ना append array को या कुछ भी तो नहीं होगा नहीं इट्स if let statement नहीं तो var यूज करना है तो फिर आपको ट्रेडिशनल वे में लिखना पड़ेगा पहले ऑब्जेक्ट लाओ और फिर उसको nil से कंपेयर करो नेक्स्ट स्टेटमेंट इट्स कॉल्ड if let मींस यू आर कन्वर्टिंग इनटू अ कांस्टेंट एंड इट्स नॉट if var करके स्टेटमेंट नहीं है This is not the way. Then you have to use the traditional way, na? The other languages. You get the variable, and then next line you compare with the if statement. आप ऐसा statement लिख नहीं सकते हो if var. ये allowed नहीं है. This is not allowed. वो नहीं चलेगा. It says if let. If var कभी नहीं आएगा. You are saying why? Wait,
wait. I just did it well. I did it like in my. Yeah.
This is for handling and this is for registering. Okay, typically people refer to register and launch only. Okay, and this is your capturing of launch events. So remote notification is pointless now. Okay, the other ways which is used. Okay, so now but only one thing is left in settings and capabilities. Right now you don't do it on. You don't have any profile map with that thing. So when you say on, it'll check whether that profile which you have added. Now during deployment, I'll show you the profile concept, app IDs, and all those concepts. Okay, and there you have a settings to on your notifications and all. So वो इससे compare होगा और यहाँ पे वो tick mark करेगा कहाँ सब valid है. And when everything is valid, it's done. Clear everyone? Okay. So post lunch, what I'll show you one 15-20 minutes, how to handle the flow. कि अगर मेरा ऐसा notification आया तो I want the user to go to task module directly, right? अगर chat का है तो chat screen पे चालू होना चाहिए user, away from home screen to that chat screen, right? So that thing, how do you handle? It's always you handle from here only. Okay. So I'll just give you that flow. Okay. And that flow is all user defined. It's not fixed. ये इतना fixed है. So any notification bound app will have this many things in your app delegate. Okay, clear? And all standard.
Local notifications also work like this.
No, local notification has a different callback called did receive local notification. Okay.
But the flow would be
same.
Permissions, etc.
Nothing. So that's called did receive local notification. उसमें ये सब conditions नहीं आएगी. तो did receive local notification में खाली एक ही है वो user info आएगा. जो notification payload we have to create. That's something can call UI local notification करके object होता है. जो आप create करते हो. And that has a key called fire time. Fire date. That date and time you have to define. Everything else you can define whatever you want. Key value pair. So whatever key value pair you will define there. Will come as a user info. And then you can take it from there. Okay? So it's not like Android and all, where if a phone reboot ho gaya, to aapke sare local notification khatam ho jayenge and wo ho jate hai. iOS mein sab manage hoga. Okay? Everyone? So we'll close here. Post break, we'll see how to capture the notification. Capturing notification happen. How you process it. Okay? Processing is all user case to case defined. Okay?